Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
Welcome to all of you. Welcome to the house of the Lord. And welcome to my television audience. And welcome to my YouTube audience. And welcome to any other audience that will be hearing the message from the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
It is good to be in the house of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Well, in today's message, I want to present to you what I believe is the best and greatest news possible. The best and greatest news possible. Now, I know for those of you listening on YouTube, you might be thinking, wow, did I win the lottery? No. No. I'm talking news bigger than the lottery. Or maybe your candidate became the president of America. No. I'm talking much bigger than whoever becomes the president of America. Even though America is the greatest nation on the face of the earth. And right now, by the way, right now in America, it's all a circus of politicians. All vying for power and condemning each other and criticizing each other and believing the little schoolboys or schoolgirls in a yard, you know, in a schoolyard, vying for attention. What a bunch of jokers. But you see, it's not just in America. You know what's most funny? Pardon me, for those of you listening to me in the television audience, isn't it funny how adults can behave like fools?
Amen.
Total fools. And isn't it funny how, more funny or even worse, how millions of other Americans will follow these fools?
Yeah.
Yeah, the world is desperate. The world is desperate. So I want to talk about a subject today that's going to get to your heart. I want you to listen well. I speak to you the truth. Here at Ambassadors of Christ Ministries, we make one thing clear. We respect no opinion of any man unless it comes from the authority of the Almighty God.
Amen.
So take this book in your right hand and say it with me. This is the Word of God.
This is the Word of God.
I believe it.
I believe it.
I will study it.
I will study it.
I will teach it.
I will teach it.
I will preach it.
I will preach it.
And I will live by it.
And I will live by it.
For the glory of Yeshua.
For the glory of Yeshua.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Yes, I don't care what the New York Times says, or the Washington Times says, or the LA Times says. I don't care what the White House says, or the Black House says, or the Green House says, or the Hen House says. I don't care what the Supreme Court of America says. When it comes to matters of theology and righteousness and the future of mankind, only one authority is my authority, and that's the living God, who is the author of this book, the Holy Bible.
Amen.
Amen. There are no ifs or buts or ands, and there is no argument. I don't argue with God because I am not the creator. He, Almighty Yahweh, is the creator. Amen.
Amen.
Man is just a little wind, a little breeze that blows through and is gone. Man is a fading flower. You know, he springs up and he has his day in the sun. He makes millions of dollars and he fluts his wings and he struts his whatever, and then he's dead. You go down 6 feet. And then what? And then you face the living God and you face judgment.
Yes.
A judgment there, then you'll see who God is. Let me be very clear before I get to this message. Whether or not you believe in the existence of God doesn't change the fact of his existence.
Amen.
Your belief isn't truth. Your belief is just your belief based on your background. God exists, has always existed, and will always exist, and you will stand before the holy God on judgment, and God will make a decision. You will either be sentenced to hell, or you will be in the kingdom of God forever.
Amen.
It's that simple. Amen. You don't have to like me. You don't have to like anything. Truth cannot be changed.
Amen.
Man may alter, attempt to alter God's word. You can't alter God's word. Only God can alter his word. And he said he is a God who changes not. Amen.
Amen.
My subject today is not one that's popular. It's one that people will not like. But you need to hear this message.
Yes.
The end of Satan's kingdoms.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Praise
God. Hallelujah. My God tells me that Satan's kingdoms are about to collapse.
Yes.
Glory to God.
Amen.
I long for that day when all the kingdoms of men, from the days of Adam until now, are about to collapse and come to its total demolition and destruction, and the kingdom of the living Christ will reign forever and ever and ever.
Amen.
That's the biggest news there is. That will make all the headlines. I love to see that headline when it says, the kingdoms of the world are demolished. Christ is now king.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
King of kings and Lord of lords. Glory to God. And all these wicked, evil politicians, I spoke about that a few weeks ago, trusting in Christ and the politicians, because let me say it again, politicians are liars, politicians are thieves, and politicians are murderers. Most of them are.
Amen.
It's in their DNA. They rule for their father. Their father is Satan.
Yes.
I'm going to show you how Satan's kingdoms will come to an end. But now, if I talk about Satan's, the end of Satan's kingdoms, Obviously, I should show you where it began. You can't talk over the end unless you understand the beginning. Amen?
Yeah.
So we need to get to, you know, the beginning and what has happened. And this is a message that I wish I had hours and hours and hours to show to you the truth. And I say this in love. I say this in love because ultimately, here's the point. You have a choice. You're either a part of Satan's kingdoms, in which case, your end result is where he ends up, hellfire, Gehenna. Or you're a part of God's kingdom. And if you are striving for God's kingdom and seeking first his kingdom, then you will end up in the kingdom of Christ. Yes. And that's forever and ever and ever. Amen?
Amen.
So it's your choice. The option, the choice is yours. You can continue to walk the path of man's kingdoms, which are all under the power and influence of the devil. Or you can say, I choose to be under Christ's government. Because I want to be in the eternal kingdom, a kingdom of peace and prosperity and love and joy and abundance for all humanity. Amen?
Amen.
And all the presidents promised that. Anybody delivered yet?
No.
Boy, they're big on promises. They're big on hugging babies. They're big on saying, and they're all lying, lying, and more lying because their father is a liar and their father is Satan.
Yeah.
So the news I present to you is bad news for Satan. This is good news, the best news for us who believe, but for Satan and the leaders under him, it's the worst news because their kingdoms are about to come to an end. Blessed be the name of the Most High God.
Amen.
I look forward to that. You see, dearly beloved, the truth is this. Whether or not you want to accept the truth, you can pretend all you want. You can hide under your PhDs and your degrees and your college education and under all the fancy and flashy clothes you want to wear and make a big hullabaloo about it. So what? You will die.
Amen.
The truth is this. This world is getting worse by the minute. America is getting worse. You know, some almost 8 years ago, a certain man promised to change America. And he kept his word. He changed America for the worse.
Yes.
Yes.
And Americans, including Christians, fell for the lie, the big lie. You don't put your trust in man. You put your trust in the Almighty God. Amen?
Yes.
So ever since sin, now where does it start? When did Satan's kingdoms begin? It all began after sin entered the Garden of Eden. For those of us who are believers in the Word of God, this is the beauty of knowing God's Word. God's Word, the Bible, answers all the questions. You know, it's funny how philosophers and psychologists and various organizations will spend millions and millions of dollars doing research. For what results? Zero. Research that produces nothing. Look, when God speaks, there is no research to be done except to pick up the Bible and see what God has said.
Amen.
And what God has said, that is your truth.
Right.
Truth is not relative, but my truth is your. There is only one truth. It comes from the Bible.
Yes.
Not the Quran. The only truth comes from the Holy Bible because only the Holy Bible was inspired by the living God.
Amen.
The Quran wasn't inspired by God. The Quran was inspired by some other being, not the God of the Bible.
Amen.
Not Yahweh, not Jesus Christ. Amen?
Oh, yeah.
So we must understand truth. This world is getting worse by the minute, worse by the hour. You think of any nation, think of any country on the face of the earth. America, Canada, Australia, Europe. Turkey, look what's happening in Turkey. Iran, Iraq, you think of all the nations in Africa, they all the nations of Asia. Tell me one country where people can live in peace and prosperity and happiness. None! And there will never be one until the kingdoms of Satan are demolished.
Amen.
I long for that day. He, Yeshua, is my King. He is my Lord. He is my Savior. He is my God. He is the lover of my soul. He is the one who died on Calvary's cross for my sins.
Amen.
Amen.
Lord.
No president of America dies for your sins. In fact, far from that, they take everything you've got until they kill you. They send you in a grave earlier. That's the problem. So ever since sin in the Garden of Eden, the kingdoms of the world are the kingdoms of Satan. This world, believe it or not, whether or not you like it, is under the control of Satan. And under the control of Satan means three important things here. Deception, darkness, and death. The three D's. The three D's of the devil. He's the fourth D. He's the first D, the devil.
Yes.
And with the devil you have darkness, deception, he deceives. Satan is the great deceiver. And when there is deception, there is darkness. So people walk in spiritual darkness. And the consequences of spiritual darkness is death. Not just physical death, eternal death.
Amen.
And eternal death means eternal separation from the living God.
Mm-hmm.
And you know what's sad? Here we are in 2016. We do a survey of the world, and we look at all the nations of the world and recognize the problems of mankind that are mushrooming, escalating at a phenomenal rate. And there is no government that can do anything to stop it. In fact, in most cases, the governments are the cause of the problems. Because the governments rule on behalf of Satan. They rule for Satan. They are proxy for the devil. Did you get what I just said?
Yes.
It is like how we have the Hezbollah as proxy for Iran, right? The Hamas proxy for, or Syria as proxy for Russia, whatever. Well, let me tell you something. The governments of the world are proxy for Satan. Amen. The worst is yet to come. How does it all start? When did it all start? Well, let's look at the Word of God. Amen. We can go to the book of Genesis and we'll go there. But I want to do something here right now. See, I have a book here that I wrote that God has given me the privilege to write. And the book's title is The Final Solution. The final solution to the Jewish question and the human problem. If you understand the solution to the Jewish question, then you also understand the solution to the human problem. Because the same solution applies to both. The solution to the Jewish question is the solution to the human problem. The problem of the world is not the Jew. The problem of the world is the human being under the direction of Satan. And this book answers those questions. In fact, now this message, The End of Satan's Kingdom, this book goes into great detail explaining the origins of Satan's kingdom, the reign of Satan, and the fall of Satan. Satan will fall. His days are numbered, and the devil knows his days are numbered. And that's why, because he knows his days are numbered, he's doing everything within his power to make life more miserable for mankind. And that's why he's out an onslaught against Jews and against Christians. That's why Christians are being persecuted around the world. And that's why in the year 2015 was the worst year in the recorded history for Christian persecution. Because Satan hates Christians. Satan hates Christians because Christians are the bride of Christ. Satan hates Christ.
Yes.
He hates Christ because Christ is about to dethrone him. Christ is about to knock him off his high horse and put him away forever in hell.
Amen.
I long for that day. Yes. This is a book you need to read. I want to go to a few pages in this book to show you the origins of the problem. Since I already have written a book, I might as well quote from my own book. Amen. Why not? I have that privilege to quote from my own book.
Amen.
In chapter 5 of my book, The World's Culture of Darkness and Death, I want to read a section. What are the origins of this culture of darkness and death? What are the origins? Well, everything goes back to a book called the Book of Genesis. There is no book like the Bible. For those of you skeptics who hate the Bible, you hate the Bible because you don't love God. You hate the Bible because your mind is messed up by the Satan. If you really want truth, there's only one source.
Yeah.
Only one source, the Holy Bible.
Amen.
Don't believe the nonsense people tell you the Holy Bible is written by man and it's corrupted. No, their heads are corrupted. This Bible is the Word of God. I have proven it. I have lived it. This is the Word of God. Absolutely certain, 100%.
Amen.
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 So I want you to understand that. So I write, in Genesis, here's an amazing thing in Genesis chapter 1. In Genesis chapter 1, verses 1 to 3, we read, "In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth." God created the heavens and the earth, not monkeys. Not evolution. In the beginning, God.
Yes.
Not in the beginning, a lump of protoplasm in mud. No. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Amen?
Amen.
The earth was without form and void, and darkness covered the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God. So there was darkness. Darkness covered. I can't explain all of that. I don't have to. All I have to do is believe God.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
When I believe God, my life is very simple. When I believe man, my life is very complex and confused. Because men change their theories, like they change their diets or their car tires or whatever they change, their clothes. God is unchangeable.
Amen.
God is unchangeable. The Word of God says, "And so there was darkness, and the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters. Then God said, let there be light, and there was light." The Almighty God, Jehovah, spoke, "Let there be light."
Yes.
And there was light. He alone has that power.
Amen.
Nobody else has that power. Only Yahweh can say, "Let there be light." And darkness obeys his voice.
Mm-hmm.
Darkness obeys his voice. You know, we have lots of politicians think they are gods. Well, let me give a word to the politicians. For all of you politicians who think you are gods, you soon will be dead.
Right.
And if you don't know the real God, you are going to be in a place called hellfire, Gehenna.
Amen.
Amen.
So there was a time here when physical darkness was present. And it's very, very instructive and enlightening to recognize that when physical darkness was present, the very first words of God were, let there be light. Let there be light. God's very first words, as recorded in the book of Genesis, are, let there be light. Well, what do you think happened now? The very first act of Satan after God's creation of man and light was to bring spiritual darkness upon the earth. God said, let there be light physically. God created man, Adam and Eve, after his image and likeness. Satan comes along and he brings them under spiritual darkness.
Yes.
So that from the Garden of Eden, listen a while, from the Garden of Eden until this very day, until Messiah comes back, humanity is no longer in the image of God. They're in the image of Satan.
Amen.
Spiritually speaking. In the image of Satan. Do you get it?
Yes.
And that is why Satan controls the earth. Yes. Satan controls all the kingdoms of men. Yes. You can take a world map. And you'll see, we'll go across all the nations of the earth, including the United States of America.
Amen.
Controlled by Satan.
Yes.
Christians, wake up. People of God, wake up and believe God. Believe the word of the living God. Believe the Bible. Mm-hmm. This is where your truth is. This is where the real answers are. This is where the solutions are found. Not in man's philosophy. Not in some book written by some current president or past president or possibly future president.
Right.
No, they only write their memoirs of their greed, their calculating greed of how they rip people off and tell you what good things they have done. They have done nothing good for people.
That's right.
It's good for themselves.
Amen.
I make no apologies for these statements because I am sick and tired of politics and politicians.
Yes.
I'm sick and tired of lies and thieves. Are you listening, everybody?
Yes.
The world needs real answers, not rhetoric, not people with eloquent flourish. The world needs real, authentic men and women who have the real God alive in them and who really care for people.
Amen.
Not who are under Satan's influence. And they come and they lie and they make their fancy promises and they give you a few dollars and give you a free cell phone. a free cell phone. And you know, people are so foolish. So foolish. Well, I got a free cell phone. Yeah, the free cell phone ain't free. Somebody paid for it. I paid for it.
Amen.
Just remember that. For all you people who are loafers and you're just free, you want everything free, it's not free. The president didn't give that to you. It's the hard-working Americans who gave that to you. Do you understand? I hope you understand that, okay? It's the people who pay the taxes faithfully and who don't steal. They have paid for you.
Yes.
So back to darkness, but darkness covered the earth. Yes, the very first sin in humanity was when Adam tempted Eve and she fell for it. And what happened thereafter? I want you to go to Genesis chapter 3, Genesis chapter 3, verse 22 to verse 24. Here's what the word of God says. The Lord God said, behold, the man has become like one of us to know good and evil. So they sin. They sin. They listen to the voice of Satan. Adam and Eve first listened to the voice of Satan. Then Adam listened to the voice of his wife who was deceived by Satan. And so they both sinned because both of them disobeyed what God had said. All right? So right there in the very first moments of creation, we see sin enters. Satan laughs. Ha! I got them. I got them. And then he laughed at God. See? I'm the boss around here. No, Satan, you're not a boss. God has allowed you a certain freedom for a certain length of time. Your appointed time is about over, Satan.
Thank you, Lord.
So Satan, get out.
Amen.
You don't have to get out. We'll make sure you get out.
Amen.
Christ will kick you out.
Yes.
So Matthew, Genesis chapter 3. Behold, the man, verse 22, the man has become like one of us to know good and evil. And now lest he put out his hand and take of the tree of life and eat and live forever. Therefore, the Lord God sent him out of the Garden of Eden. God basically did an eviction. He evicted Adam and Eve. He says, you no longer deserve to live in this area. You have followed Satan, therefore you go with him. Are you getting it?
Yeah.
You see what happens here now?
Yeah.
So, what do we learn from this account? You know, there are many lessons. If you dig deeply into this historical account in Genesis chapters 1, 2, and 3, and 4, that whole this first section of scripture in the book of Genesis, there's some vital things you learn. One, it was not God's original intention for man to die. God was going to give man life eternal. It never was God's original plan for human beings to die. But Satan came along, and with Satan came deception, darkness, and what? Death. Everybody, with Satan comes deception, darkness, and death. All the creams in the world and all the pharmaceutical potions and lotions and promotions and demotions can't help you. In fact, may I tell you, for those of you listening, the pharmaceutical industry of America and the world is one of the biggest areas of deception and darkness in the history of mankind.
Yep.
Yes.
And that's why most of you are still sick and you die. Because you're using their garbage. Okay? I'll give another message on the truth about the pharmaceutical industry one of these good days. It was not God's original intention for man to die. The first humans could have lived forever. Mm-hmm. They blew it. Yes. They blew it because they followed Satan. Mm-hmm. By obeying the voice of Satan, human beings show the inclination for sin. So now we have a sinful nature. Notice people are naturally sinful. People are not naturally good, you know. They're naturally sinful. To become good, they have to what? Get rid of the devil in their lives.
Yes.
And receive Christ into your life. Amen?
Yes.
That makes a whole big difference. The immediate consequence of this foolish act was that God evicted them from the Garden of Eden and he sent them out in the open. So basically what happened there was this. God was saying to Adam and Eve, you are now under the spiritual control of the one you chose. You chose to have Satan as your God. Well, he will now be your God.
Amen.
Are we listening?
Yes.
Are you understanding?
Yes.
Okay. Man, therefore, at that point, lost communion, direct communion, and the presence of God. He was driven away from the presence of God. Adam and Eve were driven away from the presence of God. And from that moment until today, that is still the same thing. Except for that time when Christ came already. And if time permits, I'll explain that. But I want to focus on the end of Satan's kingdom by first explaining to you the origins of his kingdom. Are we on the same page, everybody?
Yes.
So far we understand. So Satan got in charge. What happened to the first family? Cain murders Abel.
Yes.
The very first human family was not a model family to follow. Cain murdered Abel. Same thing, you know. You know, Cain murdered Abel, and from that point on, in fact, there came a point in the history of humanity when every thought of man was evil. In the days of Noah, what did God do? He wiped out that generation completely. Because all mankind, except for Noah, had come under the influence of Satan, the kingdoms of Satan. And God started afresh with Noah. What do you think happened? Once again, the same thing occurred.
Yeah.
And so, dearly beloved, what has been happening, the history of humanity is replete with examples of kingdoms of men run by Satan.
Yeah,
over and over and over. And I could go to scripture after scripture after scripture, which I don't have time to do, but that's why I recommend you buy this book.
Yeah.
When you buy this book, you will learn things that you have never understood before. And all the problems of humanity that are currently occurring in your own life, in your country, or in the Middle East, will suddenly come to light.
Amen.
And then you will know what to do.
Truth.
So that the truth will set you free. Amen?
Yes.
The truth will set you free. Do you want to be free?
Yes.
Well, the truth, only the truth can set you free. Only the truth, God's truth, not your truth. When you look at the world today, let's take a look at the world today as it is. Here are some things that are evidence that Satan runs the earth. Satan is in charge. I have a list of 20 items that I want to just quickly identify for you. One, the educational system of the world, including America, rejects the God of the Bible,
yes,
but welcomes Satan.
Yes.
In America today, you can't use the Bible, but you're allowed to use the Quran.
Hmm.
Well, the author of the Quran is Satan. Oops, did I just say that? Yeah, let me say it again. The author of the Quran is Satan, not the God of the Bible.
Amen.
And that's why the schools will accept the Quran and reject the Bible.
Yes.
Satan is in charge until Christ comes. Two, the entertainment industry glorifies sin of every type.
Yes.
Hollywood glorifies sin, glorifies a lifestyle. You know, you think of some names, and I will not call any particular name because you know what, those names are not worthy to be called in my lips.
Amen.
But there are many men and women who make millions of dollars selling their bodies.
Yes.
May I just say to those women and men who sell their bodies, God created you. You didn't make your own bodies. And that beauty that you think you're selling, you have perverted it. And unless you repent, you will die eternally.
That's right.
Number three, the applause and the legalization of the lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender lifestyle, the LGBT. Make no mistake about it. It matters not what psychologists say, psychiatrists say, philosophers say, politicians say, or the Supreme Court of America says, they too are all under Satan.
Amen.
Yes.
They therefore say what Satan, their boss, tells them to say.
Yes.
The LGBT movement is 100% satanic.
Yes.
It is therefore the product of the satanic kingdom.
Amen.
Absolutely no justification. Oh, Pastor, you hate us. I hate no one. I hate no one. I declare to you God's word.
Yes.
You make a choice. You believe God's word and live, or don't believe it and you die. You spend eternity with the boss, your boss. If your boss is Satan, then you belong to him. You spend time with him. If your boss is Christ, you spend time with Christ. Amen. Number four, the deliberate attacks on the Holy Bible and anything Christian. Have you noticed in America? Now, I use America because I can't use India because Christianity is not a religion. It's Hinduism. So Christ isn't present except for the Christians who are there. I can't use the Islamic countries because in Islamic countries, they kill Christians by the hundreds, by the thousands. All right? Christians are not welcome. And if they are Christians, they better shut their mouths, because if they open their mouths for too long to say anything about God, the Bible, they will lose not only their mouths, but their heads.
Yeah. Mm.
Number five, the obsession of Hollywood with satanic movies. Mm-hmm. Have you noticed how Hollywood is obsessed with satanic movies? Okay. And by the way, you Christians who go to see satanic movies, what are you doing? You are supporting the kingdom of Satan.
That's right.
You ought not to be spending your money supporting the kingdom of Satan. Support the kingdom of the living God. Yes. Amen, Christ.
Yes.
Number six, the popularity of books that ridicule the Bible. Have you noticed how books that ridicule the Bible are very important? Like, wow, we discovered something. You discovered nothing. You just discovered that you are a product of Satan.
Right?
That's what God has discovered about you. Number six. Number seven, the support of Islam, a cult of death. Islam is a cult religion of hate and death. It's a political system designed by Satan himself to destroy Jews and Christians and enslave the whole world to Satan.
Yes.
No apologies for that, Satan. If you're offended, then you need to be offended.
Amen.
So that you can get your head right with God. Amen.
Amen.
Number eight, the widespread rise of Islamic terror groups all over the world. Why is that a... You know what is amazing? To show you why this is Satan's kingdom? Everybody knows that they have terror groups, but they are increasing. And the governments of the world do nothing.
Right.
Just really stop it.
Right.
Satan is advancing his evil kingdoms.
Yes.
Number nine, the emergence of Chrislam, an unholy, syncretistic unity between Christians and Islam. There is absolutely no connection between Christianity and Islam. Christianity is of Christ, of the Almighty God, and Islam is not of Christ, it is of Satan, his kingdom.
Amen.
Number 10, the deification of feelings and experiences truth. Your feeling isn't truth. Satan wants you to, what did he tell Eve? Go take a smell. Don't you see Eve? Feel it. Touch it. Don't you feel it in your bones? That must be good for you. Yeah, right. And that's what people do. I feel. Excuse me. Don't bless me with your feelings. Bless me with God's word.
Amen.
Your feelings are not my truth.
That's right.
Your feelings are your feelings. And the funny thing about feelings, as you know, your feelings today may not be your feelings tomorrow.
That's right.
Amen.
Yeah.
But truth today is truth tomorrow.
Amen.
Amen. Number 12. The growing acceptance of Eastern philosophies, Hinduism, Buddhism, yoga, meditation. You know what amazes me? There are Christians who have God, the living God, reject Christ to accept Buddha.
Yes.
Buddha? A dead man? A dead man awaiting resurrection? Well, are we crazy?
Yeah.
We accept Hinduism? Hinduism with 300 million gods? I mean, is that crazy or what? Where they worship monkeys and elephants and cattle? Are you kidding me? Wow, Lord help us. I could go on forever, but time doesn't permit. All I'm saying to you is this. You could get a lot more if you would buy this book. The final solution to the Jewish question and the human problem. Okay, are we understanding this clear, loud and clear?
Yes.
So Satan's kingdom has deceived the world. The fact of the matter is, let's fast forward. When Christ came to the earth, many 4,000 years after the creation, you know, Satan tried to mess up Christ, trip him up.
Yes.
Imagine Satan, who was initially created by Christ. Understand this.
Yes.
Lucifer, right? I don't have time to go into those specific historical and theological details. But he wasn't created as Satan, he was created as Lucifer. Right?
Yep.
And the creator is Christ. Amen?
Amen.
You have God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. Satan therefore knew this person, this man, the incarnate God, who he really is. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Now watch an encounter. Open your Bibles to Matthew chapter 4. Matthew chapter 4. What an amazing encounter. In Matthew chapter 4, I am amazed when I read the Word of God. Satan has an encounter with the Lord Yeshua, Jesus the Christ. And in this encounter, in one of the episodes, beginning with verse 8, the devil took him up, this is Jesus, on an exceeding high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world and their glory. Now listen up, everybody. We're going to spend some time here. My sermon is the end of Satan's kingdom, right?
Yes. Yes.
The devil, basically, how did he do it? I don't know exactly how he did it. I wasn't there. But you know what? It's reported by Matthew, right? It's like a news reporter reporting, we're not there, we don't know what exactly happened, but this is what we're told. So Satan shows Messiah, Yeshua, who is the creator, the world, and he says, all these things I, Satan is saying to Jesus, all these things I, Satan, will give you if you will fall down, bow down, and worship me. Let's read this again. I don't want you to miss this. Verse 8. The devil took him up on an exceedingly high mountain and showed him what? All the kingdoms of the world. You see, the devil recognized that he could do that literally because legally, the very God who had created him had given him the legal authority over the earth. Yes, you heard me right.
Yes.
The Almighty God had given Satan legal authority over the earth. Unless God, Yahweh, had given the authority, he couldn't have it, right? So God had given him the authority. So Satan, he's boasting in his best. He says, look, Yeshua, look, see all the kingdoms? Look at the Roman kingdom. Think of it, right? At that time, the Roman kingdom. But it's more than that. Think historically before that. You know, we could go back in history for those who like history. We could go back to all the kingdoms that we are aware of. The Egyptian kingdom. Anybody knows about the Egyptian kingdom?
Yes.
Back then, the Assyrian kingdom,
yes.
The Babylonian kingdom,
yes.
The Persian kingdom,
yes.
The Greek kingdom,
yes.
The Roman kingdom,
yes.
And all the other kingdoms that have come since the Roman kingdom. For example, the Islamic kingdom,
yes.
That's a kingdom, you know.
Yes. Yeah.
1.6 billion of them, right?
Yeah.
How about the Catholic kingdom? That's a kingdom in Europe too. Yeah, the Catholic kingdom. How about the American kingdom?
Yeah.
Yeah. How about the Chinese empire?
Yes.
How about the British empire? You get my point? So we can look historically 6,000 years ago and bring it now to 2016, and here's what Satan is doing. Hey, Yeshua, look, all these kingdoms. Look at the glory. Look at New York City. Isn't this beautiful? Look at LA. Look at Tokyo, Japan. Wow, isn't this all beautiful? Listen, I can give all of this to you if you will just worship me. Are we understanding?
Yeah.
You know, Yeshua never said, excuse me, what nonsense are you talking? Those kingdoms don't belong to you. Here's what Yeshua said to him. Let's go to the Word of God. Verse 10. Jesus said to him, away with you, Satan. Away with you, Satan. Get lost, Satan. For it is written, you shall worship Yahweh your God, and him only you shall serve. Jesus said, Satan, shut up. Let me tell you something, Satan. I know what you're trying to do. You think by you offering me what kingdoms I have allowed you to have? Excuse me? That's almost, if I may use a refrain, that's like a parent. You give your child this whatever big gift, right? And the child comes to say, Daddy, Mommy, I can give this car to you if you would just worship me. And you know, your parents, as a parent, say, excuse me, I don't need you to give me that car. Okay? For now, it's yours. When I'm ready, I can take it away. How about that? You get my point?
Yes.
For now, it's yours, son. When I'm ready, I'll take it away. Jesus said, away with you, Satan. It is written, you shall worship Yahweh, your God, and him only you shall serve. Praise God. Satan was able to offer, so to speak, in the legal way, the kingdoms of the world, because legally he was given authority to rule the kingdoms of the world. Most pastors don't preach these things. Because I tell you what, most pastors are busy building their own little kingdoms. And the kingdoms are based on money and lies.
Yeah.
Satan's kingdom is based on money and lies.
Yes.
Listen, I'm going to tell you the truth. I will speak the truth even if I die penniless.
Right.
You get my drift? Because I'm called by the living God. I represent the kingdom of Christ.
Yes.
A real kingdom that's about to come. Amen?
Amen.
I have no glory in the kingdoms of humanity. They all stink.
Yes.
Beneath that veneer of civility is a nasty, stinking, rutting mess.
Yes.
Are we understanding that?
Yes.
John chapter 18, Passover week. This was the last Passover week of Christ. The last Passover week that he would celebrate before his crucifixion. And we are at that point in the calendar when we're going to get there in a few days, or a month or so, Passover. In John chapter 18, there is an encounter with Pilate. I want you to notice carefully how the encounter goes. John chapter 18, are you there? Verse 33. John chapter 18, Pilate is cross-examining Jesus, and here is the conversation. I begin in verse 33. Pilate entered the praetorium again. He called Jesus and said to him, are you the king of the Jews? Are you the king of the Jews? Jesus answered him, are you speaking for yourself about this? Or did others tell you this concerning me? I like Christ's response. Do you know this? Why do you use the word king of the Jews? Pilate, trying to be funny, I suppose. Pilate answered, am I a Jew? Your own nation and the chief priests have delivered you to me. What have you done? Jesus answered, these are beautiful words. I just love these words. These are my favorite words in the Bible when it comes to understanding the kingdom of God. Jesus said, my kingdom is not of this world.
Amen.
If my kingdom were of this world, my servants would fight so that I should not be delivered to the Jews. But now my kingdom is not from here. What was Jesus saying? Yeshua was saying, Pilate, you don't really understand. You see this current state of affairs here with you in charge and the whole Roman kingdom? And all of the kingdoms of the world, all these kingdoms currently, they belong to the devil. My kingdom is none of this. I don't want this. I have a better plan. Amen?
Amen.
And we're going to talk about that. Good. Satan's kingdoms will fall. But let's go further in the narrative. Verse 20, verse 37. Pilate therefore said to him, are you a king then? Pilate wants to press the point because, you know, if he says he's a king, that's a good charge for treason. So you want to take over the kingdom, the Roman kingdom. You're guilty. Jesus answered, you say rightly that I am a king. For this cause I was born. Watch carefully, church. I'm going to watch carefully. Those of you in the audio television audience, listen carefully. For this cause I was born. What cause? To be king.
Amen.
King of what? We're going to get there. For this cause I was born. And for this cause I have come into the world. That I should bear witness to the truth. Everyone who is of the truth hears my voice. You who are listening to me, are you listening to the words of Jesus? If you love truth, then believe Christ.
Amen.
If you don't love truth, then reject him and believe Obama. Believe King Obama or King Trump or King Clinton or whoever the king or queen is. Believe them and see where that will take you. Are you listening?
Yes.
Believe the UN. See where that will take you. Believe the lies of the Islamic Empire and see where that will take you. Straight into Gehenna fire. Because they don't speak the truth. Because they don't know the meaning of the word truth. Are you understanding?
Yes.
I'm just telling you like it is. This is not a popular message. Because the fact is, truth isn't popular. Truth is never popular. Are you listening?
Yes.
Truth is never popular. Jesus wasn't popular because he was not speaking what Pilate wanted to hear. Amen. He said, yeah, I have a kingdom. How do we know this? Well, now, keeping in mind what Christ just said to Pilate, go back to when he was born, right? Just before he was born, what did the angel tell Mary? Luke chapter 1. Watch. This is putting the word of God together. We see an amazing, amazing connection. Luke chapter 1, Mary receives a vision, all right? And a visit from the angel. Gabriel visits Mary, and Mary is startled. What a strange visit. Oh, what even stranger the message? A very strange message. So, verse 29. When she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and considered what manner of greeting this was. The angel said to her, do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb, and shall bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Yeshua. That's the correct name. You shall call his name Yeshua. Everybody say
Yeshua.
What?
Yeshua.
He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God will give him, the Lord God as the Father now, Yahweh the Father, the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, meaning in the human realm, right? David is seen as the father of Jesus because of the genealogical line. I don't have time to explain that, but that's simply a matter of recorded documentable history. Now, he shall be given the throne of his father David, now verse 33, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. How long?
Forever.
How long?
Forever.
4 years?
Forever.
8 years?
Forever.
16 years?
Forever.
100 years?
Forever.
We got it. He shall reign forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
So when Jesus was standing before Pilate, I wonder if Pilate knew the scripture.
No.
33 years before that, what had happened? The angel Gabriel said, Mary, you're going to give birth to a son. And your son, Yeshua, will be king over the children of the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom, there shall be no end. Amen?
Amen.
The word of God is clear. Now, the question, of course, is when will this be? Has it occurred yet? No, it hasn't occurred yet. No, we still see the American kingdom standing. It will not stand much longer. We see the Islamic kingdom expanding. It will not expand much longer. Are you getting my point?
Yes.
All the kingdoms in history have fallen, you know. Right? The Egyptian kingdom is gone. The Assyrian kingdom, the Babylonian kingdom, the Persian kingdom, the Roman kingdom, they've all fallen. Right? The British Empire has fallen. All the kingdoms of men will fall. Because all the kingdoms of men belong to Satan. Satan's final demise is about to come.
Amen.
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 We give God some praise for that.
Amen.
Satan's end is about to come. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
His end is about to come. I thank God every day. Hallelujah. He's going to be finished with. Over, done, finito. He's a liar, a thief, and a murderer. That's what Jesus said. Amen. Now, we know when this will come because the Bible tells us. Now, I mean not in terms of a precise year, but in terms of sequence of events.
Yes.
If we understand the prophecies in the book of Zechariah and Daniel and Revelation and Matthew and Mark and Luke and John, and we connect them all together, there is a sequence of events which have to be fulfilled. And when that sequence of events is fulfilled, Messiah comes.
Amen.
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 Let me take you to two or three scriptures with the last time I have left. In Daniel chapter 2. Daniel chapter 2. Daniel, a major, mighty servant of God. God revealed to Daniel the outline of world history. Amen.
Amen.
And Daniel wrote, Daniel was a captive under King Nebuchadnezzar in the year 605 BC. And he was writing this prophecy that God gave to him. So in Daniel chapter 2, Nebuchadnezzar had received a vision of an image. And he didn't understand the image. And God, Yahweh, gave Daniel the interpretation. All right? So I want to read verse 44. Daniel chapter 2. In the days of these kings, what kings? Well, the kings, the kingdoms that were going to be the Babylonian kingdom and the Persian kingdom and the Greek kingdom and the Roman kingdom and the kingdoms that will come thereafter until the final kingdom, right?
Yeah.
So here's what Daniel said. In the days of these kings, the God of heaven will set up a kingdom. What will God do? Set up a kingdom. It's not yet done.
Nope.
It is yet to come. God will set up a kingdom which shall never be destroyed.
Thank you, Lord.
Never. The American kingdom is about to end. Did you know that?
Yes.
You know, America isn't going to rise again, church. I have bad news for you. I have really bad news for you. For those of you thinking that America will rise again, make America great again. No, we're not making America great again. Our days are numbered.
Yes.
We have been weighed and found wanting in the balances.
Amen. Yes.
This kingdom is done.
Yes.
Like a British kingdom, American kingdom is over. I'm sorry. But you know what? I'm not really sorry because I'm looking forward to a better kingdom.
Yes. Amen.
Aren't you?
Amen.
Who wants to live in a kingdom of mistrust?
No.
A kingdom of murders? A kingdom where women are oppressed? Where women have to... How many people go to jail? I don't know the number. How many abortions we've had? 57 million? 57 million? You want to live in that kingdom? A kingdom where we have no respect for God any longer? A kingdom where Christians are murdered? No, I don't want that kingdom. So this kingdom says, in those days, God will establish a kingdom which shall never be destroyed, and the kingdom shall not be left to other people.
Yeah.
Other people. It shall break in pieces and consume all these kingdoms, and it shall stand forever. It shall stand how long?
Forever.
How long?
Forever.
How long?
Forever.
No earthly kingdom will stand forever.
No.
Satan has had 6,000 years. Friends, brethren, Satan has had 6,000 years. His 6,000 years are almost over. Blessed be the name of the Most High God.
Amen.
In the book of Zechariah, if you go to the book of Zechariah in the Old Testament, chapter 9, we get a further understanding of the fact that Satan's kingdom will soon end and a new kingdom will come. Chapter 9, this is Zechariah chapter 9, verse 9, verse 10. Rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion. Shout, O Jerusalem. Behold, your king is coming to you. Behold, your what? Your king. King and kingdom go together. King, kingdom. King, kingdom. Behold, your king is coming to you. He is just and having salvation. Lowly, riding on a donkey. The colt, the foal of a donkey. Did that happen already? That prophecy was fulfilled. That prophecy given by Zechariah in the year 518 BC. 518, that's 500 plus years before Christ came. Right? Was fulfilled at Christ's first coming. He came into Jerusalem in the Passover week riding on a donkey. Verse 10, second part of the prophecy. I will cut off the chariot from Ephraim and the horse from Jerusalem. The battle bow shall be cut off. He, meaning this Messiah, Yeshua, he shall speak peace to the nations. He shall speak what?
Peace to the
nations. This is not John Kerry and his baloney. Hey, that guy is a total moron.
Yes.
I'm sorry. He knows nothing at all.
Right.
But he's not of the kingdom of God.
Nope.
So how can he know the truth?
Right.
All right, so please understand that if you were in his shoes, you would be doing the same thing, talking nonsense. The Bible says, here's what Christ will do. Not the UN. The UN can't bring peace. The UN has failed miserably. He, Messiah Yeshua, shall speak peace to the nations. His dominion shall be from sea to sea and from the river to the ends of the earth.
Amen.
So when Messiah comes, he demolishes all the kingdoms of man, which are Satan's kingdoms, and he will establish a kingdom from sea to sea to the ends of the earth. Amen?
Amen.
It will not be, you know, kingdom fighting kingdom. No, no, no. Here we have, you know, the Roman kingdom fighting the other kingdom. The Roman kingdom fought the Greek kingdom. They gained the supremacy. And then you have the Muslim kingdom, the Ottoman Empire. How many of you know about the Ottoman Empire? That was a Muslim kingdom. And then eventually the British defeated them. And then you had the British kingdom. And now America is the greatest nation, the American kingdom. And all the kingdoms are fighting for power. The Chinese dynasty and the American kingdom. Guess what? They all lose. Messiah Yeshua will establish his kingdom forever.
Amen.
From the ends of the earth, from the river to the ends of the earth.
Amen.
Hallelujah. It is coming, right?
Yes.
Let's go further. Revelation 11. I want to share the good news. This is the best news. You know what? Americans are going crazy today. You know, who will be the next president in November? Quite frankly, I don't care. I don't care because I've looked at the history. And you know what I see? Every president gets worse.
Yes.
America is getting worse because we have rejected the God of the Bible. And instead of the God of the Bible, we have brought in the Quran.
Yes.
And we're avoiding all the other witchcraft and voodoo and all kinds of satanic rituals, right? And we have kicked God out. We have destroyed the family structure. No longer but a husband who is man and a wife who is female. It's about whatever makes you feel good, you do it. It's all about love. I miss it. Love. Well, if you love a dog, marry a dog and have sex with a dog too. And some people do that too. It's absolutely crazy. That's what happens to the mind of a man when you don't have God. Do you understand that?
Yes.
When you are far from God, your mind becomes depraved beyond understanding.
Yes.
Do you understand?
Yes.
Spiritual emptiness leads to satanic completion.
Yes.
Did you get it?
Yes.
So the more empty you become spiritually, the more filled with Satan. It's one or the other. You can't have both.
Amen.
It's one or the other. Either the darkness of Satan's kingdom or the light of Christ's kingdom. Which shall it be?
Amen.
Revelation 11. Revelation 11. Before I go to Revelation 11, you know, I need to go to Luke 23. I'll show you why. Let's go to Luke 23. Remember when Messiah was on the cross, he was dying. Remember there were two thieves with him on the cross?
Yep.
One on either side?
Yes. Uh-huh.
Well, there is something one thief said which I find very, very prophetic.
Yes.
Very significant. Let's not forget what he said. So let's go to Luke 23. Luke 23. Very important. Luke 23. I don't want you to miss this. This is the gospel. The gospel of Luke. Chapter, what did I say? 23. Okay. So here was Jesus on the cross in the middle. Verse 39. One of the criminals who were hanged blasphemed Messiah, saying, "If you are Messiah, save yourself and us." Taunting the Lord. Even as the Roman soldiers were taunting the Lord. Even as happens today in America, that our political leaders taunt Christ. They disrespect Christ. No reverence for Christ. They are just like that thief. Boy, does it fit or not? They are just like that thief. Taunting and mocking our Savior. The other thief answering rebuked him. Here is a man who is about to die. He's on the cross. He's a thief. He deserves to die. And he has the wisdom and the prophetic insight that God must have given him at that moment to see something. The other thief answered, rebuked him, said, "Do you not even fear God, seeing that you're under the same condemnation? We indeed justly, for we receive the due reward of our deeds." He's speaking to the other thief. So you and I are receiving the due rewards for our deeds, our evil, our theft, our murder, whatever it is. But this man pointing, I suppose he's trying to lift his finger. If he could do that because he's nailed on the cross, maybe he pointed one finger. This man has done nothing wrong. This man has done nothing wrong. We can't say that about Muhammad. Muhammad's whole life was wrong. Do we understand? This man, Jesus, has done nothing wrong. Wow. And then he said, incredibly, these words are beyond my mind. "Lord, remember me when you come into your kingdom."
Hallelujah.
Lord,
amen.
Remember me.
Yes.
When you come into your kingdom.
Thank you, Lord.
Jesus has a kingdom, church.
Yes.
Friends, Christ is coming back. A kingdom will be established. You can be in or you can be out. It's very simple, the choice you have to make. Nothing I say is to hate you. I want to see you live forever. God wants you to live forever. I'm not asking you for your money. I'm not begging for anything. I'm begging you to receive Christ, because that's the only hope. You want to trust in the next president of America in November? Go ahead and trust and see what happens. You will be disappointed again. You want to trust in the UN? Go ahead. You will be disappointed again. You want to trust in the Chinese Empire? Go ahead. You will be disappointed again. You'll be wearing only Chinese, eating Chinese food. I'll kill you. You want to distrust in the Islamic Empire? Go ahead. You will die. You will get your head cut off. Messiah is coming back. Revelation 11, I can't go there. Revelation 11 talks about Messiah coming back. And then the kingdoms of the world will become what? The kingdoms of our God. I have to go there. Revelation 11, very quickly. I got to go there. I want to see it with your own eyes. Revelation 11, this is my final verse, and I'm done with you for this. Revelation 11, verse 50. "Then the seven angels sounded, and there were loud voices in heaven saying, 'The kingdoms of this world have become the kingdoms of our Lord and of his Christ, and he shall reign forever and ever. The kingdoms of this world have become the kingdoms of our Lord and of his Christ, and he shall reign forever and ever. Are we listening, church? Christ is about to return. He is returning victoriously, and he will establish the millennial kingdom. But before he establishes the millennial kingdom, he will remove Satan completely. He will cast him out. He will bind him for 1,000 years. Satan will no longer have access to human beings. And then eventually, after 1,000 years, he will be cast into Gehenna, the lake of fire, where he and the Antichrist and the false prophet and all the peoples of the world who supported his kingdom will be there with him to spend eternity. Come, Lord Jesus, come. Make your decision and be sure that you will be in the kingdom of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach. Amen. 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 And amen.